Space Dragon and Kim.
Oh no, Kim! Help! My brains are falling through my nose!
Wait. Your brains are not falling through your nose. That's snot. You're just sick.
Oh, thanks. You're pretty sick yourself, bruh.
No, what? What I mean is there's a tiny virus inside your body and your cells are trying to like beat it to a pulp to get it out of you.
So there's like a mini sumo wrestling match happening inside of me? That's hilarious.
That is very true. So imagine, if you will, that your nose is a knight. Yes. And it is standing guard at the castle wall trying to stop the party poopers from getting in to the queen's ball. So how do you think this nose knight is gonna stop these party poopers?
Snot?
You are correct! You see, the inside of your nose is lined with a mucous membrane that constantly is producing snot, also known as mucus. Now, normally the nose catches the bad stuff and throws it away through a sneeze so it can't infect you.
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
Sometimes the virus sneaks past the mucous membrane by disguising itself as something less harmful. Sneaky, sneaky guy. Now, when this happens, you get sick, okay? But the next line of defense are these protein things in your body called cytokines. Yeah, cytokines. Now, they send cells to go attack the virus and basically signal to your nose that it's time to start producing way more boogers to stop any invaders from getting in. Kind of like a police officer calling for backup. So your nose fills with mucus and then naturally it starts to drip out.
Okay. So that explains the dripping schnoz. But what about all the other pointless things my body does? Like, why do I get scabs? Why do I pass gas? Why do I burp? Why do I ralph when I'm sick? Why do I wake up with weird, gross, green, crusty things in my eyes?
This calls for a super simplified lightning answering session where I answer stuff about stuff to the max!
Great segment name, Kim. Really just kind of rolls off the tongue, eh?
I know, it needs work. You just let it go. Start the counter!
Ready, set, go!
You get scabs because your body has its own built-in bandage maker. Just like your nose, your skin doesn't want to let bad things into your body. So, let's imagine for a minute that this loaf of bread is your knee, okay? And let's imagine that you scrape your knee.
Oh no!
Okay, you scrape your knee like really badly. Okay, so this is your scraped knee.
Okay.
Like this. Now your blood sends these special cells called platelets to cover your broken skin. Okay. And let's use this delicious strawberry jam.
Yum.
To represent our platelets. So I'm gonna get right in there because these platelets, they happen and there's lots of them. And
ew.
There they are. They just like slop, they slop all over it. Gross. Like, but it's wonderful. Okay, so these platelets stick together like super glue and they keep the bad things out of your body while the white blood cells inside heal the skin underneath. Amazing. So don't go picking those scabs. Promise me.
Promise.
Okay.
Now do farts and burps.
Okay. Farts and burps. Now, burps are actually pretty easy. So, when you walk around as a human being, you breathe, you eat, sometimes you get air or gas inside your stomach and it's gotta come out somehow, so you burp. Farts are a little trickier. You see, we have this bacteria living in our lower intestine right now.
Gross. There's creatures inside of me? Get them out!
No! Don't hate on those creatures, because they are doing a good thing. In fact, these little monsters inside you are actually helping to break down the food that you eat. And when they do that, they create some stinky gas, including hydrogen sulfide, which leaves your body, you know, from your butt and smells terrible.
Yeah, that's right. The planet Uranus is actually made up of a lot of hydrogen sulfide, and it stinks like rotten egg fart. Seriously, you watching this video right now, look it up. The planet Uranus that sounds like a butt actually smells like a butt. Anyway, we're almost out of time. Why do we throw up?
Blowing chunks. You spew when you're sick to get rid of viruses in your belly. Like this.
I'm back with the vice chaser.
Whoa! Okay, so why the eye goop in the morning?
Okay, so your nose, like your eye, needs to produce mucus to keep all the bad stuff out of it. But your eyelids kind of act like windshield wipers keeping it clean. So when you're asleep, your eyelids are obviously not moving, you're not blinking, it's not cleaning, so you get a bunch of gross stuff in the corners and it looks awful and it's terrible.
Okay, oh, so what you're basically telling me is that my body is like an army protecting me against invaders, and its best line of defense is to just like do a bunch of really gross stuff? That's hilarious!
Yes, you are correct! That is true, but for now, you should really get some rest so that you can heal and get better, and I've got to get back to my homework assignment because it's due in 5 minutes.